The GTX 1060 has been the go-to GPU for mid-range 1080p gaming, but does it hold up in 2018? Howdy, howdy guys, Ponchato here, and today we're taking a look at Nvidia's GTX 1060 3GB graphics card. The 1060 was released back in August of 2016 at a launch price of $199. It's equipped with 1,152 shaders and runs at a core clock of 1506 MHz. The 3GB model, as the name implies, comes with 3GB of GDDR5 VRAM running at 2002 MHz on a 192-bit memory bus, giving it a total memory bandwidth of 192.2 gigabytes per second. The 1060 is rated for 3,935 gigaflops of floating point performance and has a TDP of 120 watts. Because of that, Nvidia recommends a 400 watt power supply as the minimum, and this card does require a 6-pin PCIe power connector. The specific model we're looking at here is the Asus Dual GTX 1060-O3G. This one comes with a dual fan cooler with two heat pipes and is just less than 10 inches or 255 millimeters long. A fairly large card, but still short enough that it should fit in most non-mini ITX cases. This one, like most 1060s, comes with one DVI, two HDMI, and two DisplayPort connections. The test setup today is my tank build with an i5-7500 and 8GB of DDR4 2400 memory. Let's get started with the benchmarks. First up is Battlefield 1. On low settings, the 1060 averages 172fps with 1% lows around 90 and 0.1% lows above 50. Stuttering is rare and almost imperceptible. Medium settings bring the average to 136 with lows around 80 and 60. High settings average 95 with lows at 64 and 45. And finally, ultra settings drop it just a bit to 87fps average, 1% lows at 57 and 0.1% lows at 41. If you're aiming for 60fps, the 1060 can easily handle ultra settings, and if you're on a 120 or 144Hz monitor, medium settings will work well. Next is CSGO. Low settings hit 292fps average with lows at 152 and 74, while medium settings average 274 with lows at 140 and 72. Maxing the game out drops the average to 242 with lows at 88 and 30, though you'd be hard-pressed to notice stuttering in-game. Low and medium settings are so close that I'm skeptical these are limited by the CPU rather than the 1060. Regardless, you can run the game on max and even a 240Hz monitor won't be held back, though if you have a 240Hz monitor, you probably wouldn't be using a 1060 to begin with. Third in line is Deus Ex Mankind Divided, and I think this is the first time I've been able to get more than 60fps in this game. On low settings, the 1060 averages 80fps with lows at 50 and 32. On medium, the average stays above 60fps with a slight dip in lows at 46 and 31. High settings average 55 and have the strange effect of bringing up the 0.1% lows, 39 on high versus 31 on medium. Very high averages 47 with lows in the mid 30s, and even ultra settings are playable, 39fps average with lows at 28 in the 1% case and 22 in the 0.1%. DXMD is still an extremely demanding game, but if you're looking for a reliable 60fps gameplay, the 1060 has you covered up to about medium settings. Fourth is GTA 5, and again we have the inescapable horrific stuttering on low settings glitch. Average FPS is 123, but the game is totally unplayable due to extreme frame drops. On medium settings though, things get better. Average FPS stays around 110, while lows hit 74 and 56. High settings average just under 100fps, with lows again in the low 70s and mid 50s. The 1060 falls just short of being a good match for 120 and 144Hz monitors, but can easily handle GTA 5 maxed out on a 60Hz monitor. Next, we'll look at Just Cause 3. On low settings, the 1060 averages over 140fps with lows at 65 and 54. Medium settings average over 120fps with lows around 50, and high settings average 86fps with lows in the 40s. I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed with this performance. The 1060 basically hits 144fps on low, 120fps on medium, and well above 60fps when maxed out. That's not bad. Number 6 in the lineup is Overwatch. It shouldn't come as a surprise that the 1060 can basically mash this game, since even toasters can run it well. Low settings run into the built-in 300fps cap, which can't be bypassed, so the real average would be somewhere north of 300. Until you hit epic settings, there's really not much to say, since the averages are well over 144fps. Even maxed out on epic, average FPS is still above 120fps, with 1% lows over 100, though 0.1% lows take a bit of a nosedive down to 77. Though it should be noted, 0.1% lows at 77fps would be extremely difficult or just impossible for most people to notice. Even if you're shooting for 120 or 144fps, the 1060 can pretty much max out Overwatch. PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds is up next. Very low settings hit 141fps average with lows at 71 and 29, low settings average around 120fps, medium settings hit 106, high settings average just under 100fps, and finally ultra settings drop performance quite a bit to 64fps average, 42 FPS 1% lows, and 23 FPS 0.1% lows. Maybe it's unfair to say Ultra settings drop it quite a bit. The 1060 still averages over 60 FPS on Ultra. It'll even work for 120 or 144Hz gaming on very low or low settings. Considering PUBG's history of horrific optimization, these numbers are pretty dang good. With PUBG 1.0 released just a little while ago, performance has actually gotten a lot better from pre-release. I'm also working on a full PUBG 1.0 benchmark for every current budget GPU with comparisons to pre-release performance, so be sure to subscribe to see that. The last game on the list is Rocket League. It's an esports title, so big numbers abound. Low settings average 366 FPS, medium settings hit 263, and high settings average 163 with 1% lows at 126, and even 0.1% lows at 107. That means even if you're using a 144Hz monitor, the GTX 1060 can max out Rocket League and still have performance to spare. Now to give a general feel for performance, we'll look at the combined FPS averages of esports and non-esports titles. First up, the esports average. These numbers come from CSGO, Overwatch, and Rocket League at 1080p. Low settings average around 300 FPS with lows around 210 and 140. Medium settings average 260 FPS with lows around 180 and 150. And finally, ultra settings average 176 FPS with lows at 106 and 71. Basically, the 1060 can max out esports titles with no trouble at all. Next, we'll look at the non-esports averages. These numbers are the combined results from Battlefield 1, Deus Ex, Just Cause 3, GTA 5, and PUBG. On low settings, average FPS is 132 with lows in the mid-50s and mid-30s, though the lows are thrown off a bit by GTA 5's low settings quirk. Medium settings average 108 FPS with lows at 63 and 45, and high or ultra settings average 74 FPS with lows at 49 and 37. Based off this, you can expect the 1060 to max out most games at 1080p and 60 FPS and handle 120 or 144 FPS on low-ish settings. Now for power consumption and temperatures. As usual, I need to point out that comparing GPU temperatures is difficult because almost every single graphics card uses a different cooler, but these results are good for a ballpark estimate. Temperatures were taken in a room at 24 degrees Celsius, power was measured at the wall for the entire test setup, and temperatures were allowed to stabilize for 15 minutes before being recorded. Sitting idle at the desktop, the GTX 1060 settled at 49 degrees Celsius and drew 31 watts. Under load with Unigen Valley, the 1060 peaked at 77 degrees Celsius and drew 161 watts. Quite a bit more than most other GPUs I've reviewed, but it's also quite a bit faster. One note on the idle temperature, the default fan curve allows the fans to completely turn off, which is why the idle temperature was so high. After setting my own fan curve and leaving the minimum speed at 25%, it idled at 37 degrees Celsius, which was much closer to other GPUs I've benched. It's really just up to personal preference whether you want to do that. I do want to make a quick note about this specific model. If you set the fan speed to anything under 20% but above zero, it doesn't maintain a constant speed. Instead, it spins up then slows down every second or so depending on what speed percentage you set, which is kind of annoying. My guess is they screwed something up with the PWM controller, but the good news is it's an easy workaround. Just don't set your fan curve to go below 20%. Even at 25% speed, the fans are only spinning at a few hundred RPM, so they're barely audible. Now the part I like most, FPS per dollar. These numbers are the combined average of all 8 games at 1080p and medium settings divided by the current market price for the GPU. Just under 0.7 frames per dollar puts this a good bit under cheaper GPUs like the 1050 or RX 550, but if you need the performance the 1060 offers, your only other option is an RX 580, which will cost you about twice as much. With computer components, higher priced parts typically have worse price to performance than their budget counterparts, and the GTX 1060 is no exception. In its performance bracket, however, the 1060 is actually a pretty good deal. If you're looking for a card that will basically max out any game at 1080p, Nvidia's GTX 1060 is the cheapest and really the best choice. The next step up in performance would be a 1070, which go for around $500, and the next cheapest competitor is the 1050 Ti, which is about 40% slower. I'd like to see something like a 1060 Ti in the $300 range, which would be particularly great for people running on 1440p setups, but we won't see anything like that until, maybe, the GTX 2000 series. If you want to pick up a 1060 for yourself, click the link in the description. If you want to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up, hit subscribe, then click the bell icon to enable notifications. So guys, if you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe, and if you have any questions on the 1060 or these benchmarks, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video.